Welcome, everyone. So today I'm going to explain how are you going to build an awesome dashboard for your business. So as a beginning, I'm going to go through basically how to build a successful business and what are the key factors that is influencing. And I'm going to go through a story of a financial company and how dashboard is playing a major role and how did they build their awesome dashboard. And then I'm going to go through how WSO Dashboard Server is providing the facilities to build the awesome dashboard for you. Okay, look, so let's start to look into the key factors that influences in a successful business. So currently, like there is in the modern world, a lot of things are changing around you. And you're supposed to take strategic decisions in many times. You have to change your path. You may going in the some direction, and that direction may not suit you. So you have to take a strategic decisions and change your path so that you can win your business. And also you have to keep on changing. Basically in the modern world, people doesn't want to stick into the same thing again and again. They wanted to change very rapidly. And agility is also really, really important. So in order to get this sort of behavior and very dynamic dynamic business, you have to have a lot of insights. It's basically what has happened on your business, what is happening right now, and what could be happening in the future. So for all these things, we need the visualizations. So we need to see, okay, we have seen a lot of presentations on how can you gather this data and how can you do the analytics. But after analyzing this, everything will be as a raw data. That's not going to give you much information. Let's say like you have everything in a MySQL server, all the data is there. But if you wanted to always run through some queries and get info the data out, it's not going to give you the full-fledged results that you are expecting. So visualization is bringing all these insights into your one screen and helps you to estimate the future. So WSO2 Dashboard Server helps you to build up your visualization based on a lot of analytics that you have built on, maybe a lot of data sources that you would like to connect on. And its key factors are like dashboards and gadgets. With both of these, it is trying to give a sleek user experience. So let's look into some details about these main factors, what we mean by. So user experience. So user experience, like it mainly has four different factors that you need to think of. One is the first impression. For an example, when you see a dashboard, you have to have the full insight immediately when you see that, what it is trying to say. You should not search, okay, where is my icon and where should I go to and see for the data, what is it's trying to represent. Once you see the dashboard, it should represent all the information that you're supposed to get. So that's called the first impression. And the interactiveness. So when you click on a button or when you click on some pages, we are trying to navigate to somewhere, there should be a feedback that should be given back. Okay, this is what's happening. Okay, it may take client time. At least it should provide you a loading button saying there's some processing is happening on the back end. So there should be some interactiveness. Then intuitiveness comes into the play. So when we are having an icon, it should itself should say what it is doing. We should not go to a documentation page and see, okay, so what is this icon could be and what are the operations that I could perform. So and also when you are clicking on an icon, it should take you through a wizard so that like you know, okay, what is the next step I'm supposed to provide. So that is basically intuitiveness. And then the personalization. So nowadays, no one wants to have the same dashboard or same view which everyone else is seeing. So I wanted to add some more what makes sense for me, and I have to rearrange it and see in my own way. So these are the main user experience, and this is the main thing that we are trying to focus from the WSO Dashboard Server as well. So next key point is dashboard. So as I have already explained you, dashboard is the page which connects a lot of factors and gives everything in a consolidated manner on a single page. Whereas you can see business intelligence, KPI, metrics, everything together. So that dashboard is basically consolidating a lot of gadgets, which could be connecting to different data sources. Maybe let's assume it could be a batch data analytics data, or some databases, or some external legacy APIs. It could be anything. So it's basically connecting all these factors and providing you a dynamic HTML page for you, like HTML container. So gadgets, if we consider gadgets, so we are basically using Google Gadget Standards. So it mainly have a specification file and an XML representation where you can specify whether it is an HTML or you are going to provide some JavaScript functions and you are going to deal with the gadget. Whereas you can also have your own stylings, everything. It's a sandboxed environment within a gadget. And then the container page. So in the WSO2 dashboard server perspective, container page is the WSO2 dashboard server page itself. Then it connects to an external data source. So as I have already told you, like it could be a legacy application, anything. So it's supposed to, it connects all the data sources that you are interested on your business domain into the one visualization. Okay, so these are the main key points. Okay, now let's see actually what is expected for an awesome dashboard. So let's go into some use case. So let me introduce John, a CEO of a finance company. He's a CEO of Finance Harbor. So this finance company is basically trying to provide loans for individuals, companies, and so forth. And also there are a lot of investors who are investing so that they could give the loans, as well as they are trying to invest on different business domain. So he has a problem. So he was like wondering, okay, he's getting monthly reports, weekly reports, everything. But that doesn't give him enough evidence, so it's not basically giving him enough insight what is happening on the system. So he wanted to get some interactive dashboard so that like he could see, okay, total, what are the transactions that has been happened on my system, and how's my money flow, etc. So he calls his designer Nancy and tells, okay, he wants this dashboard. So as a normal CEO, he puts a deadline just in a week. So, okay, so Nancy basically, as she was given this task, she was coordinating with a lot of analytics people and the gadget authors, and come up with a proper dashboard, okay, which will give you what are the total transactions that has been happened, money flows, everything. So which basically connects with their some legacy applications that they are using in the finance company. But there is a problem. So this particular dashboard, what she has built is, it's not somewhat very secure. It could be seen by all of the employees in the organization. So once the dashboard is introduced to John, so he was like looking that, and he was not really that happy with that, because he wants to have the total information, but also he wants to narrow down and go to the level. Okay, what are the transactions that has been considered for this calculation? So he wants to go to the minor level and see, and so that he can have a better insight. And then the security aspect. So he doesn't want this particular dashboard to be shared with all the employees in the organization. So that needs to be shared only by the board of directors. And for their strategic decisions, they wanted to see this one. So this after all these changes, okay, Nancy comes back and forth. There were several meetings, and Nancy was able to build up the dashboard. Now basically John gets this dashboard and introduces it to the board of directors. So there is a board of director called Peter. So he's also a CEO of another company. And now what he's asking is, he wanted to integrate one of his organization dashboard also, some gadgets also, with the same page, so that he can see, okay, how these two organizations are performed. But in that case, he doesn't want that particular newly added gadgets and information should not be viewed by all the members, because that's something that he wants to only see there. So which brings the requirement of personalization. So again, this information was conveyed to Nancy, and Nancy was trying to coordinate with the newly Peter's organization and trying to get these gadgets incorporated and personalized only for him. So with all this information and it's a sleek dashboard design, finally John and board of directors was happy and were able to take a good strategic directions for their finance company. which concludes this particular story. So you can see, in order to develop as awesome dashboard, one thing you have to develop very fast. There is no much time that you could invest in order to make it very, very, very sleek and so forth. But the sleekness is supposed to be incorporated with your dashboard. Then it's supposed to be personalized, and there is a concept called security. So there are all other features, requirements are coming into the play. So a WSO2 dashboard server will provide all of these features and something more. So let's look into some basic architecture. This is what WSO2 dashboard server looks like in a nutshell. So you will be getting the data from different data sources, and you have to build your own gadgets. So in the WSO2 dashboard server point of view, like, we are not actually building the gadgets for you. So gadgets is basically, as I already mentioned, is a Google gadget spec. So you can build your own gadgets. Once the gadgets are added, you can have an intercommunication gadget. Let's say, like, you click on some gadgets, and the information is supposed to be passed to another gadget so that it refreshes by itself, and it shows the data. Then all these things are connected in the dashboard. It communicates the results back to the user. So this provides the architecture how WSO2 dashboard server is being built on. So if you see, like, as other WSO2 products, we have the WSO2 kernel, and we are mainly using a Jaggery, which is a server-side JavaScripting language, in order to build our application, which we call portal application. And on top of the portal application, all these logics are being handled. We have modules, tools, and themes to cater different themes providing some additional features like SSO and stuff like with modules. And store is basically where we keep our resources like assets, something like gadgets, layouts, and stuff. So this is the basic architecture of WSO2 dashboard server. Okay, so now let's get into the features from WSO2 dashboard server, which is actually providing you to develop your own personal dashboard. So one thing, rapid dashboard creation. Just few clicks, you can end up in the dashboard. You doesn't need to do any customization, nothing. It's just few clicks, you will end up in a good dashboard. And you can centrally manage the dashboards as well. Every dashboard comes into the same place. And if you want to do some management, you can connect to finance dashboard, you can connect to sales dashboard, you can connect to engineering dashboard. Anything could be connected and into the central place. And also, we do deployment with the WSO2 Carbon Application Archive strategy, where you can put all your dashboards, gadgets, everything once you have built on as an archive and pass it to different environments, and you can deploy it in different servers. So let's go through the flow, how you actually create a rapid dashboard. So this is the first page you will be landing on. You click on the create dashboard, you fill the name, what is your name of the dashboard, and URL, how you wanted to actually have it on your URL, and provide some description if you want. Then you will be end up in a different page. Okay, now the dashboard is created, so you have to create a page. So the page could be in any layout. So there are some default layouts that has been given. If you don't want to use any of these default layout, you can go with a blank layout and add your own blocks. Then once this is done, dashboard is created. This is how the dashboard listing page, where you see the centralized dashboards. So this is this much easy. This particular place, I didn't actually go and try to drag and drop any gadgets. So this is just a blank dashboard I have created. So now let's go into how are we going to drag and drop gadgets. So once you have created a page, you will be having blocks, which you can drag and drop gadgets from the left pane. So in this particular picture, like, I'm dragging and dropping a US map into my gadget block. So it will just render immediately. In case if there is some user preferences that you would like to change it, you can always change it on from the right pane. Okay, so now let's get into the topic, the pages and dynamic layouts. Okay, so now I have already mentioned, like, you have to create a page in order to navigate between a lot of pages in the dashboard. So you click on the page, and then you will have to select a layout. Then let's assume you have selected a blank layout, which I have already mentioned, like, if you don't like to go with any of the default layout, you can go with the blank layout, which doesn't have any blocks by default. Then you can select your block, what is the size of the block that you would like to include it in the page. So once a block is already added, you basically still, if you are not satisfied, okay, maybe it's my, I have selected a wrong size, I want to expand a little bit more, you can still do it by just dragging the block. Just simple as that. So this will actually give you the way how you can build a dashboard with a very minimal thing. You don't have to have in a static way, this is how it's supposed to be. You can change it as your mind changes. And then the role-based access. So in the previous John's example also, we were thinking like, okay, only the board of directors supposed to be seen the dashboard, not the all the employees. So in that cases, you would like to have some restrictions. Basically say, okay, these are the viewers, the dashboards who should be able to see, and who are the other users that who could actually edit the dashboard, who has the privilege to change the entire dashboard such that it will be reflected to all the users. So in that previous place like you, as you can type the role name, it will, you can all automatically select, and you can say, okay, these are the roles of the viewers basically who can see the dashboard. So in this example, viewer, admin, and designer can see the dashboard. And there are some editor roles which we can say, okay, designer and admin have only the edit privileges, no one else can edit it. And then the requirement of personalization. So now you have built up all the dashboards. Now it's similar to what Peter's requirement, where he wants to map his organization, some other different organization gadgets into this particular dashboard. So he will be like in this WBSO dashboard, so we have this ability. So you can click on the top box, red color box. It is shown in the right-hand side. And then it will take you to the personalization on page, whereas you can change the layout, you can move around the gadgets, you can put additional pages, anything that you can do. But this one will be only reflecting to that particular user's dashboard, not anyone else. And then inter-gadget communication. So this is basically very important if you are dealing with a dashboard, because let's say like, let's take a simple example, like you wanted to monitor some logs or some sequences. Let's say ESP, they wanted to actually monitor the transaction that has been happened. So by default, it will show you the hour-related data or real-time data. But then you wanted to actually drill down, go to a specific particular place, let's say like in this minute what has happened. And I wanted to go through the each messages and see, okay, what has happened. So when I click on the each gadget, it's supposed to explore and see. So which is basically an inter-gadget communication scenario that we are talking about. So in this particular example, this is a USA demo, it's a USA map. You can click on the each of the US states. So it basically say how much of the female, male, ratio is being there in the state and so forth. So let's say like I click on some state, so it basically self-adjusts the other gadgets also by taking those details into the account. So this is very easy in the WSO2 dashboard server context. There is already a Shindig feature exposed with this. So you have to have a method like basically a callback register to that feature, and you can write any of the logic that you wanted to incorporate with this one. So these are the very basic features that we have, but we do have many other features as well. So I'll just go through what are the other features that we do have. One is like a important feature I would highlight is themes per dashboard. You can apply your own theme. You don't need to necessarily go with your by default WSO2 dashboard server theme. You can have your own organizational theme, or like for an example, if you wanted to have a finance dashboard a different theme and sales dashboard another theme, you can still apply that. And then custom dashboard banners, you can upload images and have your own banners as well. And anonymous dashboard view, let's say like you can have always the dashboard secure, not to be logged in with any, like also all the users supposed to be logged in into the system to view the dashboard. That is one option, that's what we have already seen. But there is an anonymous view also you can provide. Okay, there is like, you don't need to log in, but there are some basic information which is not really secure that can be transferred to the users. And then you can maximize minimization gadget is already there, and carbon application deployment. And specifically, we do support multi-tenancy also. So you can, by default, it's carbon.super is our super tenant. You can create any tenant, let's say foo.com, and all the dashboards, gadgets, everything is isolated from the super tenant. Nothing is shared. So there is a tenant isolation. And then we do have integration perspective. We can integrate with as a SSO with identity server, and we can communicate with the REST API with OAuth support. And also we do support mobile devices as well. Okay, so these are the basic functionality which we have already in Dashboard Server 2.0. Now let's look into, like, now we are working on Dashboard Server 2.1.0, which is going to be released probably in a 2 months' time. We are still on the milestone stages. So let's see what are the main features that has been covered with hierarchy, like 2.1.0 dashboard server. So one is the hierarchical feature. So far what we had, it was a flat structure. We didn't have a hierarchical pages structure. So with this particular new release that we are going to have the hierarchical pages, where you can mention, okay, it's a home page and you have to go to the finance and then you have to go to the my transactions, stuff like that. So those can be, you can design very easily with just drag and drop your pages in whatever order that you would like to have. And so this is how it will be reflecting on the view mode if when you are having designed like this in the designer mode. So then we do have, we are going to incorporate a gadget generation wizard as well to make it easier life. Like instead of like asking all the users to develop their own gadgets, we are going to have the gadget generation wizard, which will take you series of steps and you can generate your own gadgets. For this, we are planning to make it pluggable. So any providers will be able to plug into the system. By default, we do support batch data source, which is basically from DAS, and real-time data source, which is basically a web service supported, but specifically for CEP. And then we do support RDBMS, so this, and there are a lot more to come. So this is the basic thing. But if you have a different, completely different data source from which is specific to your organization, you can still go and plug it. And then we have the pluggable model of putting a lot of chart templates. We do support reasonable amount, like line chart, area chart, bar chart, all those things. But if you want something totally different, then still you can go and put it. So this particular gadget generation wizard is still on the progress. So we will be releasing it with the next GA release. So I'll just walk through what we have right now. For our milestone pack, if you download, you will be able to see this. So you can select what is the provider that you are going to get. For an example, here I'm going to select the relational database provider. So once that is selected, like, I have to provide the URL via the server is, databases and database name, table, and the SQL query what you wanted to run. So in then you can basically preview your data. So that will say, okay, these are the things that you do have in your database tables. And then you can go to the next step, which is actually the configuring the chart. So this is the raw data that you are going to get in, and now you are going to select what is the chart type that you are going to see, maybe line chart, or any other chart you can select, and the preview will be shown below. Then once that is generated, it will go into the gadget store so that you can list it on the left pane, and you can simply drag and drop the gadgets and it will just display like this. And if you do want further modification, you can do. So it just, you know, like, you don't need to do anything else. You can just walk through the step-by-step wizard and get the gadget created. So these are the just two, you know, features I wanted to highlight. But other than this, there are a lot more other features also, which is going to come with 2.1.0 dashboard release. One is the embeddable gadget support, so that once the gadgets are being developed and incorporated in your dashboard page, you can embed it on any web pages also. That support is also being available from 2.1.0. And then role-based access control for the gadgets itself, not only for the dashboards, for the gadgets also. So some certain gadgets you can, from the point that you are writing, you can restrict. This can be only seen by certain users only. Hidden pages support and multiple views support per page. For an example, if you wanted to, if you are creating a page which could be seen by different roles, but you have to have a different views for the based on their roles. For an example, like, I would like to see what are the Jira's that has been created. But as an administrator, I would like to see it in a different way. But as a developer, you wanted to see it in a different way. So all these things you can incorporate it with the multiple views per dashboard. And then we are having gadget states persistence, which is basically you can just copy the URL and give it to the other person with the drill down information of the gadgets so that they can just reload it and get the same view that you were looking at. So some more like gadgets, adding and deleting gadgets from UI, everything is there. So these are the main features that currently we are working on. And I would like to highlight WSO2 Analytics platform dashboard is being powered by WSO2 Dashboard Server. So let's look into some complete implementations. So this is basically WSO2 ESB Server, how we have done the dashboard. You can see like we have the full picture of how much total request has been gone through and all those things. And still people can drill down and get these information. So this is basically will say what the tracing flow of a sequence. And you can maximize a particular gadget and see how this actually looks like. So and another example, like in a mobile world, how they have developed the dashboard by using our WSO2 Dashboard Server. Okay, so that's all.